Yeah, so I'm going to talk about black hat data science. I've been doing data science for about 10 years. I started a consultancy called Meta Optimize. Okay, so I'm gonna talk quite quickly, so I don't know, put your phones up. Wow, this is really not working for me. All right, so data science is a tool. And like any tool, it can be used for good, and it can be used for evil. These are evil people. And when evil people apply a certain level of technique and finesse to their work, we call them black hats. So black hat, I mean, people talk about black hat quite openly in the internet marketing community and the security community. We don't have these sort of discussions in data science. I think that's thankfully because we don't have many expert level black hat data scientists. I think the reason for this is because data science comes out of academia, out of the ivory tower, out of the quintessential white hat institution. So take home point, we don't have any black hat data scientists yet, at least not experts that I know of. Now, on the other hand, I would argue that most industry data scientists are gray hats. If you're working on advertising and you prioritize advertiser needs over consumer privacy, then you're a gray hat, right? There's this entire spectrum of gray hat activity. It's not all so there's this entire spectrum of gray hat activity, right? Even white hat SEOs, some of them have been exposed, been doing gray hat activities. If you go a little darker, right, I would argue that there are companies that aren't straight up black hat, but they're definitely on the darker side of the spectrum. So anyway, most industry data scientists, I do believe, are engaged in some sort of gray hat activity. What is the sexiest job of the 21st century? DJ's never going to live this down. So he wrote an article where he said, the sexiest job of the 21st century is being a data scientist. And in this article, without any sort of irony, they go on to point out that the sexiest job of the 1980s was being a quant. A quant, who's now universally reviled and demonized, right? How do we know that in 10 or 20 years, we're not going to be the ones that fucked up the world, right? So what is the sexiest job? So I'm not trying to make some sort of like black and white argument about like, oh, you know, finance is bad or data science is sexy. What I am trying to say is that if it's the case that our predictions are correct, that the big data market is going to become increasingly lucrative, then in this case, we're going to attract more unscrupulous actors. All right, so here's a thought experiment, right? So Hillary Mason, when she gives when she starts a new research question, one of the questions is, what's the most evil thing that can be done with this? Oh, it's purely a creative exercise, right, Hillary? Yeah. So is Hillary Mason a good data scientist? So let's just take the, like, Google, which maybe I'm naive. I think they're white hat, right? Let's take Google and turn on its head, right? What if a well-funded organization decided to be strategically evil and then also loaded up on top like data scientists? What would they do? What are their attack factors? I'm not going to talk about military or, for that matter, political application. I'm only going to talk about economic ones. So one approach you could do, you could just take an existing black hat internet marketing technique and then use data science to scale it in an undetected manner. Two patterns you might use, stealing other people's data, and I think more importantly, manipulating influence. So you might use human-like bots. A lot of bots right now are really easily detected, but if you applied, I think, some technique, that wouldn't be the case. You can also build on cheap human labor, like Mechanical Turk. For manipulating influence, I think these are all just different sides of the same coin. For example, if you have fake traffic that you drive to a fake website and generate fake ad click-throughs, you just committed ad fraud, right? A lot of ad companies say that this is easy to detect, but on the other hand, if you were able to apply, I think, a certain level of expertise, you might be able to do large-scale ad fraud undetected. Second of all, using new language models from NLP, I think you could generate really good spam. In general, you could. There's some really cool talk. There's a really cool talk on. Well, anyway, it's basically about social media manipulation. You could also do just old school pump and dump, right? So I think there are these lucrative attack vectors that are available to data scientists. So I don't really have much time to go into these, or for that matter, to talk about potential defenses to these attacks. I'll just end with this note. Well, we don't have black hats yet, but a lot of us are gray hats. We'll probably get black hats soon. There are lucrative attack vectors that are available, and there's this open question of which of the attacks can we defend against. So Hammerbacher, he kind of famously said, the best minds of my generation are thinking about how to make people click ads. To that I would counter, well, at least they're only gray hat.